ஆழ்வார் எம்பெருமானார் ஜீயர் திருவடிகளே சரணம். ஜீயர் திருவடிகளே சரணம். ஸ்ரீ பகவத்கீதா 15th சாப்டர் புருஷோத்தம வித்யா இஸ் தி டாபிக் டிஸ்கஸ்ட் பை பகவான் இன் திஸ் சாப்டர். பகவான் எக்ஸ்பிளைன்ஸ் அபவுட் ஹிஸ் ஓன் நேச்சர் அண்ட் தி நாலேஜ் விச் இஸ் டு பி நோன் அபவுட் ஹிம் இன் திஸ் பர்டிகுலர் சாப்டர். பகவத் ராமானுஜா has given a beautiful Sanskritam commentary for Bhagavad Gita named Shri Bhashyam, Shri Gita Bhashyam. Vedanta Acharya has given Tatparya Chandrika, which is another beautiful Sanskrit Vyakhyanam. Uttur Sri Vivekrishna Swami Iyengar has given elaborate Tamil commentary for Bhagavad Gita based on these two Sanskritam commentaries. In this grantham, he has also given word-by-word meanings for each shlokam. We have translated that into English and have made that available in our website, geeta.coil.org. With the help of this translation, we are going through the simple meanings for each shlokam. We have seen up to the 15th shlokam in this chapter. Up to this 15th shlokam is like an introduction. From the 16th shlokam, Bhagavan is explaining about Purushottama Vidya. In the 15th shlokam, he said that he is the one who gives memory, forgetfulness and knowledge to Jivatmas by being inside the Jivatma. And he is also glorified as the one who is spoken about in Vedam. He is revealed in Vedam fully. So such Bhagavan is speaking to Arjuna and he is explaining the concept of Purushottama Vidya, topic of Purushottama Vidya. Let us see from the 16th shlokam. Dva vimau purushau loke ksharas chakshara yevacha ksharas sarvani bhutani kutastokshara uchyate. Let us see the word by word meanings. Loke, in shastram. Lokam generally means shastram because the whole world is sustained by shastram. Hence, when there are references to lokam, it many times points to shastram. So similarly, here also in shastram, sacred texts. Ksharaha cha aksharaha cha dvau imau purushau eva. Two types of souls, that is kshara, baddha jivatmas, bound souls, who are with destructible material body, the material body which will come to an end. Such body they are having. Hence they are known as Kshara, Baddha Jivatmas. And then there is Akshara, Mukta Jivatmas, those who are liberated with indestructible spiritual body. They don't have body like ours. Our body is made of Panchabhutam. Muktas and Nityasuris, they have bodies made of Pancha Upanishad. So these two categories, Kshara, who is bound souls who are in this material world, in the material body, and then there is Akshara, Muktatmas, who are in spiritual body. They have spiritual body. They are well known in this world. Both of these categories are very well known. They are very famous. Kshara, Kshara Purusha, Sarvani Bhutani, all bound souls. Akshara, Akshara Purusha, Kutastaha, Uchyate, is known as Muktatmas, who have no material connection. So Kshara, Kshara Purusha means all the bound souls, all the Atmas who are with body in this material world. They are all known as Kshara Purusha. And then there is Akshara Purusha, who is liberated person. Many Jivatmas have liberated from this world and reached Paramapadam. They are known as Muktatmas and they are known as Akshara. So this is 16th shlokam. 17th shlokam. Uttamas purushastvanyaha paramatmeti udahritaha yo lokatrayam avishya vibarti avyayas ishvaraha. Yaha tu, one who is lokatrayam, three types of entities of this world, that is chit, matter, baddhatmas, bound souls, and muktatmas, jivatmas. So, there is Achit, who is not Purusha, then there is Chit who is Purusha. Chit can be Jivatma who is bound in this material world, and then there is Jivatmas who are bound in, who are not bound, they are free, they are liberated and have reached Paramapadam. So these three entities are present in this material world. Generally we see Tattva Trayam, Chitta, Achitta, Ishvara, but here apart from Ishvara, there are three entities generally. Achit, Baddhatma and Muktatma. Baddhatma is bound souls who are in this world. Muktatmas are liberated souls. Avishya, Bhagavan is pervading. So Bhagavan is pervading all these three types of entities. Achit, Muktatma and Baddha Jivatma. Bibharti, supporting them. When he is pervading, he is supporting. If you think about the body, soul, soul is inside the body, hence the soul is able to, Atma is able to sustain the body, support the body. When the soul leaves, the body falls down. Similarly, because Bhagavan is all existing, is existing everywhere in all entities, he is supporting all of them. He is avyaya, indestructible. He is not destructible. He is eternally present. Ishvaraha, controller. He is the controller. Paramatma iti udahrataha. He is known as Paramatma in Shastram. Uttamaha Purushaha, the Supreme Person, due to these reasons, Anyaha is distinct from previously explained Kshara and Akshara Purusha. So Bhagavan is different from all the other entities. Svetara Vastu Vilakshana, that is explained for Bhagavan. He is different, distinguished from all other entities who are present in this world other than him. So such Bhagavan is known as Paramatma, and he is known as Purushaha, Uttama Purushaha, Supreme Person, due to these reasons, because he is supporting everyone, he is all pervading, he is indestructible. Because of these reasons, he is the controller, he is the Paramatma, he is Uttama Purusha, he is the Supreme Person, Anyaha. He is different from everyone. So that is explained in this 17th shlokam. With this we will stop today, and then we will continue on tomorrow, and we will hopefully finish this 15th chapter tomorrow. Alvar Emberumana G.R. Thirudigade Sharanam, G.R. Thirudigade Sharanam.
To learn such valuable information about our Sri Vaishnava Sampradaya, please download Koyil, K-O-Y-I-L app from Google Play Store or Apple App Store. Our website is koyil.org, K-O-Y-I-L.org.